Good morning, all of you. So today we'll continue with the numerical part. So if you can recollect, we had a discussion of all the theoretical ideas. Now it's all about the different types of numericals we'll pick up and we'll try to work out. I think we have plenty of time. So today, tomorrow, almost 4 days we have. So we'll explore all the numericals. Okay, read the question. These are one popular way of asking questions in mains or advance. Sometimes they give diagrams, sometimes it'll be only the information language. Through that, what happened, we should interpret. Okay, look at this. A point on a rope takes 10 milliseconds to move from mean to upper extreme. So if a wave propagates on a rope, okay, let's have like this. When a wave propagates on a rope, what will happen to the what will happen to the time taken to move from mean to extreme? Shall I say the points on a rope will exude SHM. So due to SHM, what is the time taken to move from mean to extreme? Will be 1/4 of time period of oscillation. So indirectly, do we know time period? Yes, we know time period. What is the time period will be? Time period will be 40 milliseconds. Sir, how do you can write? Because time taken to move from mean to this time is what? 10 milliseconds is telling. So what is the overall for one oscillation? 10 milliseconds. So how much it will become total? Total become 40 milliseconds. So we know time period. If you know time period, can we bring omega? 2 pi by t. Okay, this will become 100, 100, 0, 5 pi, shall I write? 50 pi. Okay, I got the omega in time period. Then it covers a distance of 2 centimeters. It's telling this is 2 centimeters. Okay, there's a time taken, 2 centimeters. So what is the amplitude? Amplitude must be 2 centimeters. The tension in the rope is 32 with a linear density mu. So if you know this, can we bring k value? So v equal to omega by k. 50 pi, is it correct? 50 pi I'm writing, is it correct? Anybody check calculation once? Okay, fine. This one, I mean to say. Okay, now you know this formula. So we'll get the value of K. So it will be, omega will be 50 pi. This will be 4. 12.5 pi per meter. I think we know. And at t equals 0, one end of rope is at extreme position. So what should be the wave? So this, it will be like this. So some rough. Okay, no, so this is the amplitude. So what is the wave equation we can write it as? Y equal to A cos omega t minus, it is moving along positive, it didn't say it equals, it didn't say that one. So let me assume that the wave is moving along positive direction. Okay, kx minus omega t. So now we know value of k, we know value of omega, we know amplitude. We'll get all the things. Now, if you know k, then you can get even the lambda also. From that, you can put the marking. How to get lambda? Lambda will be 2 pi by k. Two by 12.5. 20 by 125, no? Mm. 0.16. Okay, ma, yeah, thank you. This will be the wavelength. What do you mean by this? This will become 0.16. This will be 0.32. Somewhere the midpoint of this should be 0.8. Okay, fine. So these are the ways in which we can. They may ask you to show you the shape of the rope, or they may ask you to draw the shape of the rope at t equals zero. Point 0.08, no? Yeah. Okay, fine. Look at once. Any doubt, you can clarify it. Huh? This sir, why only you're writing? I just assume, let it wave procedure. So I'll write find y of xt. Because he didn't said in what direction it is moving, no? The wave is moving along positive x-axis. Some of you are questioning that also, the wave is moving along. Okay, I agree this. So these are the very popular. So try to work out numericals of these kind also, which are very, very important for especially the objective competitive exams, what you are writing. Let me go for next part. I'll zoom it. I think okay, no? Now you are able to read. I'll read question. Maybe it was long back written. A point on a rope takes a time of 2 milliseconds to move from mean position to 1/√2 times of maximum displacement. And velocity at this position is 20 m/s. The phase difference is pi by 4 of particles separated by 0.2 meter. At t equals 0, end of the rope is at mean position and moving downward. Find y of xt. mean to 1 by root 2 times of maximum displacement. So I'll directly take help of circle. The idea of circle, what was there in SHM, no, will help us here also. Keep in mind. So this is something mean portion, what we see. This is the amplitude. So 1 by root 2 times. So 1 by root 2 times will be 0.7, or A by root 2, I'll write it. So the particle which is here will be like this. Okay, see now. So this is the thing like this. So this is the angle theta. So what is the distance? This will be A by root 2, and this is it. We know this particular time. How much of it is like a 2 milliseconds the particle will take to move from mean position to A by root 2 times of maximum displacement. Okay, now you go back to this one. So what is theta? Theta, we can write it as. Theta equal to pi by 4 radian. Then for angular displacement of theta, it will take time t. For an angular displacement of 2 pi radian, it will take time 2 pi. So this will be pi by 4, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 2 pi by t. I think 16 milliseconds. 2 to the 4, 4, yeah. Milliseconds. There's a time taken to complete one oscillation. Correct, no? Okay, let me check once. So this will be pi by 4, 8, 8. This will be 16 milliseconds is what time taken. Okay, there's one oscillation. Okay, now we know time period. So with this, what we can calculate, omega equal to 2 pi by t, so 2 pi by 16, or this will be pi by 8 omega. Okay, now what is the other information we have? And the velocity at this position is 20 meter per second. He has given the particle speed vp equal to. So what is vp equal to? 20 meter per second. Okay, now with the help of this, Vp equal to omega root of a square minus y square. We know particle speed, we know omega, we know y also, a by root 2. With that, what happened? We'll get the amplitude. So this, I'll write it.
Sir, the time is in millisecond, no, sir. So omega will be different.
Oh, I didn't write it, no. Wait. 16 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Thousand by 8, thousand pi by 8. Anybody value of this? Okay, no. Now, what is y? This is what y. V equal to omega. Omega, this will be a square minus a square by 2. Omega a, this will be 1 by root 2. So we know omega, we know p, from that we'll get the amplitude. So what is the amplitude? Amplitude will be root 2. Are you getting, very beautifully the question was being framed by me only, not I didn't copy anywhere. I just wanted like students to, because students, the moment wave sends or no, they'll start thinking about some other formula. It's testing the SHM ideas a little bit here. Okay, we'll get the amplitude. Huh? Okay, after getting the amplitude, we know omega. I want the wave speed. It's telling the phase difference is pi by 4 of particles separated by 0.2 meter. So what is the formula? 2 pi by lambda into delta x. Now you can ask question like, sir, how you brought this equation? The phase difference between two particles which are separated by distance is given by this one. let me first take it out. So let me go for a general view. It's very simple. You need not to struggle much here. In general, okay, if you have, this is y-x graph. Then the wave, let's assume the wave is moving towards right. Okay, based on this, so can we predict the direction in which the particles are moving? So they should be moving down. I think now we are in far better position. We can directly say that the points on a rope, they are moving. Now you define one wavelength. Distance between two points on a rope, which will have same phase. How you say same phase? The particle must have the same velocity. They are said to be same phase. Look at these two points here. So they're having a same phase here because both are at mean position and both are moving down. Then we'll define that as lambda, no? Can you remember? I think this was a rule what we made here. Now, shall I ask you, what is the phase difference between these two? So what is the phase difference between them? Will be 2 pi. On this one, so how you can say 2 pi here? So the formula what we have is pi is equal to 2 pi lambda into delta x. You can check it. If I take the phase of this is to be 0, the phase of this should be 2 pi. On what basis? What is the separation between these two particles? Is a lambda. Substitute here delta x lambda. Then you'll get the phase difference 2 pi. What is the phase difference between these two particles? What is the separation? This will be lambda by 2. What is the separation between these two? Lambda by 4. So now, can we calculate the phase difference between any two points when a wave is propagating on a rope? Yes, that one. So what is the phase difference between any two points on a rope? This is a generalized formula what I'll use here. Now, what is the phase difference between particles? Let me give a number. This is a 1, this is a 2, 3. I'm interested in this one. So what is the phase difference between 1, 2, between particles 1, 2? I'll use formula 2 pi by lambda. What is the separation? Lambda by 4. So this will become pi by 2. I think we are very clear, no? We know SHM. If particle is at extreme, other particle is at mean. What is the phase difference between them? Should be pi by 2. We know SHM. Go back to SHM. Similarly, what is the phase difference between 1 and 3? Now I'll take it out. I'll write it here somewhere. This is the important formula. So no phase difference between 1, 3. So 2 pi by lambda. What is the difference between 1 and 3? The horizontal separation. So this will be pi. I think we know if the particles move opposite to each other, what is the phase angle? Should be pi radian. What is the phase angle between 1 and 4? That also we'll check it. T lambda by 4. So this will become 3 pi by 2, the phase difference between 195 So like this, using this formula, what you can do, you can find out the phase difference between any two points on a rope. We can find out phase difference on a string separated by a distance delta x. Okay, there's a very important formula. Like this, the numericals will be tested. Okay. Between any two points on a string. Separated. Okay, fine. So this is something, the data. Let me share this also. Very, 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 very important. So many concepts. Next coming chapters, no, I'll be using this small elemental, small data. I'm just putting it nearby diagram so that things students can manage very easily. Okay, now let's get into the question. What is asking? What he has given? The phase difference is pi by 4 of particles separated by 0.2 meter. Shall we take help of this data? This is one generalized information. Please do remember.
Sir, Sir, phase difference between 1 and 5 is 2 pi, no, sir? In the diagram, you gave pi.
2 pi.
Okay,
2 pi.
Sir, okay.
I'll do one thing. Okay, that. Okay, no. Okay, now shall we go to the calculation? We'll take up of that formula. So no, we got some idea. I think I can finish off problem here only. We'll use that formula, the phase angle. No. What is the phase angle given? Pi by 4, 2 pi, lambda. Do we know lambda? I think for that we should know k. How to bring k now? For that we need wave speed, no? Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll come to this. First, let me bring the wave speed. Okay, we know time period. From time period, we know omega. Lambda is needed, no? Separated by 0.2 meter. We know amplitude, we know particle speed. Wave speed is needed, no? A point on a rope takes it 2 meters. So we know omega. Omega, okay, then we needed k, no? Okay, now we know particle speed. Particle speed equal to Vp equal to into slope. So do we know slope idea?
Sir, can we take delta x equal to 0.2?
0.2 meter. Delta x, we know it. Okay, from lambda we'll get from here, no? Then I'll get the wave speed. Sorry. I think, yeah. I'm unable to see that 0.2 meter is available here, no? Not visible. Yeah, okay, no. Into delta x. So we know phase angle, pi by 4, 2 pi lambda, 0.2. Anybody lambda value? One point six meter. Eight to the 16, 1.6 meter is a lambda. After getting the lambda, yeah, 1.6. After getting lambda, then I'll go for K. Pi will be 0.8. 0.8, this will be 10 by 8. 5 pi by 4. Okay, there's now we know. Okay, now I'll get the wave speed. Okay, anyway, if needed, okay, you can go for it. Huh? Okay, now I got. So, what is the wave equation? Now at t equals 0, end of the rope is at mean position and moving downwards. I think I assumed correct one, no? This is at t equals 0. I can also write it. The wave is propagating towards right. So therefore, what is the wave equation I should go for now? Y equal to A sine. He has nicely mixed up SHM with waves and sound concept. Do we know amplitude? As we have in the corner there. We know amplitude. We know omega. We know K. Substituting, we'll get the wave equation. And there is a very popular thing so which a student has to remember. I'll show the complete question. Okay, just any doubt, you clarify it. So why the shape of the rope like this only? Next, at t equals 0 is telling a point on a rope. At t equals 0, end of the rope is at mean position and moving downward. I think, is it justified? So therefore, the wave must propagate in this direction. So therefore, put t equals 0, if you draw it, the shape of the rope like this, no? Therefore, I am able to assume the equation like this here. Any doubt, please do clarify. this is something very important. If you know phase difference between two points which are separated by some distance, with that we'll get the wavelength. Getting the idea? Try to make some observation between two different points on a rope, not of a single point. Two points on a rope separated by horizontal distance delta x. So you can predict the phase difference. If you know phase difference between two points, and if you know that horizontal separation, not separation like this, horizontal separation, then with that we'll get the wavelength. This is the use of this one. Now, what is this? Like, say if the wave propagates a distance lambda, how much of phase it will gain? 2 pi. That's the meaning. The wave is present here. As it propagates a distance lambda, how much of phase it will gain? It will gain a phase of 2 pi radian. If a wave propagates a distance of lambda by 2, how much of phase it will gain? Pi radian. That's the meaning. Because as the wave propagates, what happens? It will gain phase. That is what we are trying to express in this particular thing. Okay, let me take you to the next question. Really, students have to gather the data here. Nothing big will be there. Carefully, you have to gather data. I'll magnify it. I'll read the question for you. Okay, you. The distance between two points on a rope having phase difference of pi is 0.4 meter. Let's say I'll write the values so that it will be easy for you. Yeah, read it. Time taken by the point on a rope to move from lower extreme to upper extreme is 2 milliseconds. The distance covered by a point in one oscillation is 20 centimeters. At t equals 0, one end of the rope is at lower extreme. Find y of xt. So I'll do take help of this equation again. The distance between two points on a rope having phase difference of pi is 0.4 meter. Lambda will be 0.8 meter. Okay, I got the lambda from lambda k equal to 2 pi by lambda. five by two pi per meter. Okay, I got the value of k. I know lambda. Then time taken by the point on a rope to move from lower extreme to upper extreme is 2 millisecond. Lower extreme to upper extreme, what happened? It will be half of the time period. For full oscillation, it should take 4 milliseconds. So what is the time period? 4 milliseconds. If you know time period, then we'll get omega 2 pi by capital T. Thousand will be there, no? There, 2000 by 4, 500 pi. Okay, now we got omega, we know k. Then the distance covered by point in one oscillation. In one oscillation, 20 centimeter. And then what is the distance moved from? It should be 1/4 from mean to extreme. So what should be the amplitude? Amplitude should be 5 centimeter. At t equals 0, one end of rope is at lower extreme. It's a rough diagram, huh? Rough diagram. So this is the amplitude, A minus A, this is a Y, this is X. X is in meter, Y will be in centimeter. What should be the equation of motion you're going to write? What is this? This is not a graph. It's a string itself. Shall we write y equal to minus a sine kx minus omega t, or y equal to a sine omega t minus kx? You should bring or minus a. I'll assume the wave is moving towards right. Put t equal to 0. At x equal to 0, it should be minus c. Or you assume the wave moving towards left, then you can write posterior, either one. So let me assume general, the wave is moving along posterior x-axis. So we know amplitude, we know omega, we know k. Substituting, we'll get this one. Okay, shall we go for next one? Read the question carefully. Read question and try to think. So here, shape of the rope at various instants of time. Shape of the rope at various instants of time. That is what it is being predicted here. Figure shows two snapshots of medium particle of 1 point of medium particle supporting a plane progressor traveling along positive x-axis corresponding to means. At t equal to 0.02 seconds, I'll go for color. For first, you ask primarily a few questions to yourself. It'll be very easy afterwards. There's a one thing. Next, the green color one. What is this yx graph? What yx graph should be? Shape of the rope at any time t. That's all, no? At t equal to 0.02 seconds. At t equal to 0.02 seconds, the shape of the graph, the shape of the rope will be green color one. At t equal to 0.08 seconds or 8 milliseconds, the shape of the rope will be red color one. Very nice question. Very easy also. It's very easy also. Okay, I'll proceed like this. Let me try in my own way. I do take help of the circle concept here again. So I t equal to 0.02 seconds or 2 milliseconds where the particle is here. 2 milliseconds. After 8 milliseconds, where it will be? It will be somewhere here. This will be, you call, let's take this as amplitude A. What can be this? This should be A by root 2. And what is A? A is equal to 1 centimeter. He didn't mention, let's assume that one. Don't write y-axis 1 meter, not possible. That much of wave, pulse, or the transverse wave of that much of big amplitude. We don't have instrument. Is it possible for you to wave your hand for 1 meter? At least I'm giving some idea. Try to think. Can we calculate frequency with this circle? The first very important thing is we can calculate very easily. So can we predict this angle? So I'm interested in this angle first. Theta, let me take it. What is this angle? Should be pi by 4. So we see the a by 2. So sine theta. No, what is the time? It was here at 2 milliseconds. It was here at 8 milliseconds. What is the time taken for it to travel from there to there? It will be said that the point on a rope will not move in circular path, will move vertically. So this is for our convenient. It will be like this. Okay, now what is the angle? Pi by 2 plus pi by 4. Time taken will be 6 milliseconds. For 2 pi radian, what is the time period? 3 by 4. Anybody value time period?
16 milliseconds.
16 milliseconds. Then we know frequency 1 by t. Thousand 500 by 8, 250 by 4. Anybody value? Thousand by 16, no? Okay, yeah, let's check. I think options are not there, no? Where we are. Let me do one thing. Okay, this is a by 2. Six milliseconds. This is correct, no? Pi by 4, 3 pi by 4. 16 milliseconds, is it correct? Check once. Okay, yeah, fine. This also. 3, 2, 6, 2, 4, 8, 16 milliseconds, 1 by t. 16 milliseconds, 62.5, the frequency of the wave. Okay, some correction is there. Okay, there's a frequency of the wave. After getting this one, how to get the speed of the wave? Book answer given 104. Check it once where we are doing calculation. Book answer given 104. Time taken to complete one oscillation. He's asking frequency of the wave. Huh? Okay, yeah, we are getting this much one. Okay, next afterwards. This one, how to get the speed of the wave?
Sir, from velocity, if we do, we are getting 104, sir. We'll find velocity and we'll equate it to F lambda. Like that, we are getting 104.
First, you're going to calculate the velocity, no? If you calculate velocity, then you're calculating lambda. Okay, lambda we know. Okay, lambda is how much? Lambda will be 8.
Yes, sir.
Lambda will be 8. If you know lambda, and we can calculate the velocity here. If you look at this particular thing, the peak was here, no? So what is the time taken for the peak to propagate? So it will cover 5 meters in that interval of time.
We are getting 2500 by 3, sir, velocity.
That should be the answer. Okay. Answer.
Yes, 2500.
So for to get the velocity, what we do is we just take help of this particular data. I think I need some other color. Okay, this is at extreme point. This is a delta x. So what is the time taken by the wave to propagate this distance delta x? So in what interval of time? I think I am. Okay, let me do this one. Huh? The speed of the wave given by delta x by delta t. Delta x, how much will get? 8 minus 3. Time interval will be 8 milliseconds minus 2 milliseconds. So this will be 5 by 5000 by 6. How much will get? 2500 by 3. Okay, there's no problem with this option. Now what will happen after getting this? We know the lambda. Lambda will be 8 meter. We'll assume that one. Lambda is 8 meter. From this, what happened? We'll get the frequency. Lambda, how I can say 8 meter? So this will be if I take the green color one. This will be the lambda. So lambda, what happened, will become 8 meters. So then F is equal to V by lambda. So 2500 by 3 by 8. How much will get this with this?
So 104.164.
104.16 hours. Okay, this I think may not be for a t equal to 2 milliseconds. The point is here, no? Okay, what is the problem with this one is, so it will move down. We don't know whether it will be descending or will be ascending up. What action the wave propagating also not given. Okay, that is a problem with the data. If he says about something like, it may be here also, no? Am I right? Because we don't have any information like what is the, in what action the wave is propagating, all that condition. The particle matlapen maybe like this. We don't have information of whether the particle is moving down or moving up, because for that we don't know the direction of wave propagation. I think he has not given, so therefore this cannot be advisable to take this one. I think circle method we can avoid, because we don't have information how the particle, whether it will just move from extreme to this particular point, or will move from upper extreme to lower extreme, then it will be here. So I just assume blindly here, I got one answer, but I think answer is not matching. So some data information is not sufficient to think in this way. So I'm proceeding in this way here. Okay, all of you. So I think, shall I take it out? So this, why answer is not matching means data not sufficient. But both ideas are needed. Huh? It's not that only this one. Particle may be here. Huh? It be moving. So either this position or this position or this position, we don't know. That's what happened. We are ending up like this here. Maybe I think if you check for this, we may get answer. Data is not sufficient. That's why answer is data is not sufficient. That's why answer is not matching. Okay, I'm making things clear. Huh? Okay, no. I agree. The wave is moving along positive x-axis. I know it, but what about this particular point? It may be here or here. No, you have not mentioned whether the particle will be at a by root 2 with moving down or ascending up. We don't know. Are you getting no? Is it the motion of particle is just simple like this, or it is like this? We don't know that. Okay, got this. I just wanted to have all the ideas. See, whether we'll get answer, why answer is not matching, where we went wrong. It's not that this method is wrong. The information is not sufficient for us using this method. So therefore, I'm picking up this one. How to predict wavelength? Distance between two points which will have same phase. Both the particles, so like both the points on a rope are at upper extreme. So this will become one wavelength. Okay, these are some very good numericals, huh? Where a student must have all, you should think in very different ways here. Different methods available, take help of that and try to work out. Let me introduce to the next thing. Yeah, so this is the amplitude, 2 millimeters. Very nice question. So just here too. There's a tangent drawn. So what is this diagram? There's a string again. The diagram shows of vibrating string at t equals 0. The particle P is observed moving up with velocity √3 per second. The tangent makes an angle 60° with x axis. Okay, this much of information. What is asking? Wave speed. Okay, we'll write like this. Find y of x t. this is considered best question. The diagram shows a snap photograph of a vibrating string at t equals 0. The particle P is observed moving up with a velocity 20√3 centimeter per second. The tangent at P makes an angle 60° with x axis. Find wave equation is asking. It didn't say in what direction the wave is propagating. What is the information we have? We have something like this particular point is moving up. And the tangent at point P, the tangent makes an angle 30°. So we know something like this is some particle velocity, no? So how particle velocity, slope, and the wave speed are related? We do have one equation. Vp equal to minus v into slope. So if anything directed, <coughs> 60°. Okay, this one. So we'll do one thing. What is the particle speed? 20√3. It is positive, no? Anything directed will be upward, and this will be taken negative. Anything directed towards right will be positive. I think this is a convention, no? What we have. Wave speed, I know. Slope, tan 60°. So 20√3. This is a positive slope, am I right? So plus √3. So what is the wave speed? Minus 20 centimeter per second. In what direction the wave will propagate? I got negative sign. What shall I interpret? The wave will be moving towards left. Please do remember this convention. You can't change for your convenient. I'm making things clear. So I got the wave speed. After getting wave speed, can we get the wavelength? Okay, no. I have a certain basic idea. What is that? The wave is propagating towards left. Okay, let's try to check this. How this point will be moving up. This point will be moving down. So there's some general idea what student has to develop here now by this time. And this particular point will be moving up. Okay, good. We have some information. Okay, now how you define wavelength? Distance between two points which will have same phase. Okay, now look at this particular point. It's the mean position moving up. Mean position moving up. So therefore, this should be the wavelength. So what is the lambda? Lambda will be 7.5 into 10 to the power of 5, 3.5 into, this everything is in meter, 4 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter, or this is a wavelength. Let me have water. Okay, I got the lambda. I know V and lambda. So from that, I'll bring the K. (50 pi per meter). So from this, I'll bring omega because we know V equal to omega by K. So omega equal to V into K. So this will be 20. Into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 50 into pi, 10 pi radians per second. We know amplitude. What is amplitude? 4 into 10 to the power of minus 0.004 meter, or in centimeter, what will be that one? Okay, now we know the waves, we know omega, we know k, we know amplitude. We have to write the wave equation. How to go for the wave equation? Is it having any initial phase? The first primary question. Yes, it is having some, the phase angle. How to predict that? Okay, this is a thing. This phase angle has to be calculated. How to get that phase angle? So then the equation will be y is equal to, the wave is moving towards left, so kx plus omega t plus y. And what is this? At t equals 0, it was being shown. At t equals 0, what is the value of y? 2 root 2, this is 4 sine 0 plus 0 plus phase angle. So what is the phase angle of this will be? It will be pi by 4. So then finally equation, we can write it. Okay, got the idea, no? No, I'll write one more step. Some of you are. This will become 1 by root 2. I just picked up all the different types of numericals, like that shape of the rope at various instants of time. I mean, what direction the wave is moving? Towards left here. Wave equation itself is asking. So the wave is moving towards left. Let's write that important data. What all I am discussing, these are the level of questions that are being asked in advance. If you take the advance paper, no? So you do get questions of all this kind. Any doubt you can clarify? I'll go for next question here. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that no problem. Yeah. Okay, we'll take the next question. 0, 5, 10. -5, -10. At t equals 0, it will be very good problem. I'll try to draw the better diagram. Yeah. I would have directly brought the diagrams. So I just wanted students to learn there's a curve, all this particular thing. That was the main purpose of bringing like this. Huh? Okay, let's get into. So now we have all the data. So this is at t equal to 0. This red color one is shape of the rope at t equal to 0.05 seconds. This y is in millimeter. Mu of a rope is given 0.25 kg per meter. Okay, now what is this red color? This is also a rope. At two different instants of time, it is given. Let me write, this is one. X is in meter. This is two. This is three. So what all is asking? First, we have to calculate the speed of the wave, frequency of the wave, maximum speed of the particle, tension in the string, and wave equation. What is the overall diagram? It will show the shape of the rope at two different instants of time. Shape of string, let me write. Okay, I think he's asking so many things. Okay, let's get into this one. Do we know amplitude? Yes, we know amplitude, 10 millimeter. If we can get omega, we'll get that maximum speed. Where maximum speed will be for a particle? At mean position. I'll take help of the circle. We'll draw a small circle. This will be here. Okay, this will be where it is at t equals 0. It is somewhere here. And at t equals 2, 0.05 seconds, it will be moving down. Okay, now with the total, so this will be, shall we take this is to be a by 2, and this is it. So what is sine theta? A by 2 by a, so theta equal to pi by 6. Then what is the time taken? T equals 0, it is here. Got the idea, this one. So theta by delta t equal to 2 pi by capital T. Pi by 6, 0.05, 2 pi by t. I'll get time period as 0.6 seconds. Then what is the frequency? 1 by t. Pi by 3 hertz, the frequency will be. Okay, after getting frequency, is it okay, all of you, getting the method? Just I'm not doing anything very big. Just the SHM idea, at t equals 0, the point on the rope is here. After some time, it will be here. So you may ask, sir, it may be like this. It can also happen, no? So the point will happen, will go and might have returned back. But you see the gap between them is very small, no? The point here and next it will be somewhere here like this. So it might have gone like this. What is the reason that one? Maybe the options given, what happened, you will see that will match anyone. It's not like matching both. It may happen like this also. Am I right? Okay, this is some arbitrary way of asking question. Okay, I got the frequency. So can we get the wavelength? I think he has given information. So if you look at the t equal to 0.05 seconds, let's assume that the wave is propagating along positive x-axis. Let's assume that the wave is propagating along positive x-axis here. Then what is the wavelength? Wavelength will be this distance. The wavelength is going to be this particular distance. So how much it will be like? 2 meters, 3 minus 1. I will indicate here only. So instead of going. Yeah. So what is the lambda? Lambda will be. Now you can ask questions. Why only you're taking the difference between? Because at this instant, let's assume the wave is moving towards right. So this point will be moving up. This point will be moving up. Distance between two points on a rope, which will have same phase. Then there should be the wavelength here. If you want, you can draw only the red color one and you can show that particular wavelength. Got the idea, no? Okay, after getting this one, I got the lambda. So if I know lambda, okay. 2 pi by lambda, pi per meter. If you know frequency from that, we can bring the omega. Okay. I know the wave speed. I know omega. I know k. From that, I'll bring the wave speed. So let me bring all the things. So v is equal to omega by k. Ten by 3 meter per second. Okay, after getting, fine. This will be wave speed. So I know frequency. What is the maximum speed? Maximum speed is given by a into omega. And what is amplitude? Amplitude. This should be the amplitude, no? Ten millimeter. (0.1 pi/3) Okay, time period also we calculated. Y of x t is asking how to bring y of x t. I'll show the complete. Okay, how to bring y of t? So there is some phase, no? So whose help we should take? We should go for the initial at t equals 0 only. That is going to help us a lot. Okay, that phase has to be calculated. Anybody? Again, I'll proceed with the mathematics, what we know. Y is equal to A sine. What is the value of Y? Y is equal to at t equals 0 and at x equal to 0. Okay, well, so see the simplest ways. Determine the tension is asking how to bring tension in the string. We know V equal to root of T by mu, so V square mu. All the answers, I'll round it up. There's a frequency. There's a wave speed. Next, there's a time period. Maximum speed. Next, the wave equation. Next is asking tension. So tension will be this much here. Okay, I think a student need just a patience. He must have the patience to really understand the diagram, carefully make observation, then try to work out. Transverse wave on a rope, it's a very, you can say, the initial part, what we're discussing, the basic fundamental. If you understand this, the total waves and sound chapter, what happened, you can manage. What is the meaning of sine omega t minus kx? All that we had a exclusive discussion. So a student must know all that basic background. Then okay, fine, you can do something better. When and don't depend on what, like direct some formula. Of course, like you should able to have that phasor diagram, like what we used in SHM. No, you can take help of that. And wavelength, how to calculate. See, wavelength you cannot calculate from this one. Wavelength, what happened? Again, we should go for distance between two points on a rope, which will have same phase. So like this, the multiple ideas have to be implemented here. So students here, what they do, they'll stick on to the maximum, some direct information means without putting any effort. Okay, now how looking at that one, you can get all the answers. You don't want to think that is straight away what happened. You want to write some answer, not possible. No? You have to analyze. Let me take you to the next question. Little bit different one. All both x and y are in centimeter. Now this is the wavelength. Wavelength himself he has given. The diagram shows. Of a traveling wave. At t equal to 0.3 seconds. If the crest. If the crest P was at x equals 0, at t equals 0, find y of xt. This is the crest. Yeah. So what is this? This is a string. The wavelength of the traveling wave is given by 7.5 centimeter. He didn't write any other thing, so he is directly asking find the wave equation. What is this shape of the rope? Not at t equals 0. He has given at some other time. And where is the crest? Last sentence you have to read. If the crest P was at x equals 0, at t equals 0. So we'll do one thing. We can understand better this if I go for some more specific diagram. So let's plot the information given in the question. The crash, what happened where at x equal to at t equals 0, it was at x equals 0. So how it will be? Okay, I agree this. So this was the crest. This is at t equals 0. It was here. Huh? And we know that amplitude, how much it is? 2 centimeter. Tell me like how much of distance the crest, the wave has moved in 0.3 seconds. Shall I say that it has moved 1.2 centimeter? Please do compare. Just asking, he wants students to really draw the diagram, that's all. So how much of, so don't think that the point P will move. I think I'll be giving wrong information. The crest, what happened, will be here. this point will not move. What will happen? The crust will move here. So if I write point P, it will be very, very, so like you can say like a killing that whole idea. Let me write here. No. So this, let me write Q. What are Q and P? They are points on a rope. Now at t equals 0, the crust is at Q. At t equals 0.3 seconds, the crust is at P. The sentence, I think you should explain like this only. We should assume that one. At t equals 0, the crust was at Q. After at t equals 0.3 seconds, the crust is at P. This is the idea of the problem. Huh? Let me put it here. At t equals 0. Points on a rope will not move. Points on a rope, they'll vibrate vertically up and down. That's the core idea of this particular question. So tell me, like, can we calculate the wave speed? Yes, this information is sufficient. What is the wave speed? Delta x by delta t. 1.2 centimeter by 0.3. So how much it will be? 4 centimeter per second. Okay, this is the wave speed. After getting wave speed, can we bring the wavelength? Already wavelength is there. So k equal to 2 pi by lambda. So value of k will be 4 pi by 15 per centimeter. Let me bring everything in centimeter. Now I want omega. No, if you know V and K will get the omega. Okay, now, but we don't know phase angle. Anybody phase angle? Anybody phase angle? Should be 90, no? So therefore the equation will become A cos. Put x equals 0, t equals 0, what is y? Y will be A. So don't think that only at t equals 0, they'll give information. They may give the information at any other instant of time. With that, what happened? We should manage. And the wave speed is something like how much of distance the crust has moved by the time taken. From that, what we'll get the wave speed. I think there's a second problem what I brought of this kind. You have to be careful. Any doubt, you can clarify. Any doubt, if you have, you can clarify. I'll go for next one. Okay, shall I go for next one? Yeah, fine. Yeah. We'll take the next one. Some small database one. Let me discuss. Huh? Okay, I think the phase one I covered earlier last week, no? I think if you can remember. So the phase one only what happened, we are just applying. Take next one. Okay, let me draw the shape of the rope. Four lines, no? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this will be 2 centimeter. Y is in 2, this is 1, -1, -2, 2.5. 4.5, 6.5. He has given the wave velocity. Himself he has given +40 centimeter per second. First thing, find the this is a yx graph, it is in centimeter. Find first one F, second one phase difference between points, how long does it take for the phase at a given point given position to change by 60 degrees. Find the velocity of point P. At the instant shown. Okay, now he is asking some new things. Okay, he has given wave speed and he has given some dimensions. He didn't mention further earlier what can be this. Okay, 2.5, 4.5, 6.5. So like that we can go further, 8.5 like that. So what do you mean by wave speed? This is 40 centimeter per second plus 40. What does it mean? The wave is propagating along positive x-axis. The wave is propagating along positive x-axis. How the various points on a rope will be moving? So they should be moving up. Okay, no. So now we know V. Can we get the wavelength? Distance between two points on a string. Distance between two points on a string, which will have same phase. I think 2.5, 6.1. They're having same phase. So I'll take this as to be lambda. What is lambda? 6.5 5 centimeter. This will be the lambda. Okay, lambda, I got it. So from lambda, I'll bring k. 2 pi by lambda. If you know k and if you know v, we'll get the omega. If you know omega, from that I'll bring the frequency. Okay, no, the first thing is what? We brought it. Okay, there's the frequency. Next, the phase difference between two points, 2.5 centimeter apart. So what formula I should take it? I should go for this formula. Delta phi equal to. Okay, can you remember this? So 2 pi, lambda is how much? 4. What is the separation between them? Which are 2.5. 5 pi by 4 is the phase angle between them. Next, what is asking? How long does it take for the phase at a given position to change by 60 degree? What is the meaning of this? Already I explained concept is asking a little bit of a given at a given position. So let me underline. Of a given point on a rope, anything, how long does it take for the phase at a given point on a rope to change by 60 degree, or at a given position to change by 60 degree? What do you mean by this? See, what is the point on a rope? It will exude SHM, no? So let's assume that it is at mean position. It is moving up, zero phase. This point will go up. As it moves up, phase will increase, no? So it will become from 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, then 2 pi. So at a given point, what's happening? The phase is varying with the time. Go back to SHM. Then what is the formula? We do have a formula, delta phi. But we don't know time period. It's we know frequency. From frequency, we'll bring the time period. 2 pi, this will be time period will be 1 by 10. Delta t, how long does it take? So the phase angle is given 60 degrees. 60 degrees means what we write, pi by 3. So shall we write that as 60 seconds? Getting the idea, no? So at a given point, you can take any pointer, not only point P, any point here. Like, you know, how long does it take for the phase at a given point position to change by 60 degrees? There's a formula. So we are not understanding from where you brought it. See, it's very simple. You need not to fight with mathematics. Go back to SHM. So if it completes one oscillation, tell me how much of phase it will gain? 2 pi radian. For one oscillation, what is the time period it will take? Capital T. So right here, capital T, 2 pi. If it moves from mean to extreme, what is the time it will take? T by 4, substitute here T by 4. So how much of phase it will gain? From 0, the phase will increase, will become pi by 2. Then again returns back pi. 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. Okay, I don't want to trouble students through mathematics, sir. Just as simple, like we know SHM. So as the particle moves from mean to upper extreme, again mean, again lower extreme, its phase will change from 0 to 2 pi.
Sir, delta t is 1 by 60.
Okay, this one, 1 by 60, yeah, fine. Find the velocity of point P at the instant shown. Okay, how to get the velocity of point P? I think it's quite clear. No, we know amplitude, how much, 2 centimeter. Do we know omega? Yes, we know omega. So what is the velocity of point P? Velocity of point P is given by A into omega. 2 centimeter. Omega is omega is how much we are having? 20 pi. 40 pi centimeter per second. This is the velocity of point P. Then can we write the phase angle? Because we don't have further information. Is this the shape of the rope at t equals 0? Am I right? So therefore, I'm not going for the phase angle. If he has given that it is at t equals 0, okay, we'll go for it. If it is at t equals 0, means as I know, what is the value of y at t equals 0? It is minus 1 centimeter. So with this, I'm able to predict the shape of the rope. He didn't say that at what instant of time there's a shape of the string. So therefore, writing phase will be a little bit difficult here. Getting some idea? You have to work out some problems. So some questions, they'll give diagram. Some questions, the first 3 questions, no, without diagram, I brought it. Mains will be of that kind, where they don't give diagram. Advanced, no, they'll try to prefer to ask through a diagram. Okay, students, what happened? They'll be asked a diagram. So from diagram, they may ask you some questions here. Any doubt till here, what all we discussed? If you have, you can clarify it. Any doubt? If you have, you can clarify. What is this? Speed of? Say in books open, they just say medium. Medium, they say that one. For our understanding purpose, we call that medium as a rope or a string, because this will help us a lot. Because medium will start trying to imagine. Need not. Just the rope itself, what happened, will be in the form of a sine wave. When a transverse wave propagates on a rope. So string or a rope, or some books they call a cord also. Will maximum books, they use string. So very frequently we are using rope here. But if you look at the books, no, they called sometimes medium also. So nothing, what is the medium? The rope itself is called as a medium. So if you look at the books, no, so some several books they used. Now, any doubt, if you have, you can clarify it. Okay, we'll end up the class. Tomorrow we'll start at 8 o'clock. Huh? Today I could not start earlier.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, I'll end up the class. Yeah. Thank you.